Welcome to Knicks.com here at MSG Training Center before the team heads out to Detroit on the back-to-back with the Pistons. First of all, before we get into that matchup and looking at Detroit, as a coach, what do you tell your players about back-to-backs? And, you know, I think it's 4 and 5, these types of, you know, difficult traveling situations and when they have to really bounce back in a game against, you know, a pretty quality opponent.
I think it's just about, you know, not letting yourself convince yourself that you're going to be fatigued. I think you're the mantra that we take each game as a single entity and that we come prepared to play every night no matter where the schedule is or where we have to travel to.
You know, with Stan Van Gundy taking over there in Detroit, just give me your overall thoughts. Probably watched him, obviously, with Orlando having some success and what he's done in the NBA. What is his objectives from an offensive standpoint and what he's done with some teams in the past?
Well, in Orlando, he was obviously, they had, you know, Dwight Howard in the post, and they had, you know, spread out with a lot of shooters. I think they're doing some similar things in Detroit now where they have, you know, one big guy in the middle with Drummond and then, you know, spreading out with some guys who can make some plays on the perimeter. But Coach Van Gundy is obviously always well-disciplined teams on both sides of the ball.
From a pace perspective, do they like to get the ball up and down the floor and get into their sets quickly? I mean, how do they approach that?
I think they're still trying to find their early identity. I think it's early in the year. You know, it's a new staff, new team. So I think they're still trying to develop what their system's going to be like.
Well, what we've seen in the past from Andre Drummond, he's a fantastic frontline player there, and they got some big boys down there with Josh Smith as well. How do you counter that with the frontline that you guys have?
Well, it's all about doing your work early, being prepared. You know, they have some talent, obviously Monroe coming off the bench also. So it's in terms of your mentality of, you know, doing your work early, being physical with them, trying to keep them out of the paint, because if they get their in paint position, they are pretty tough to stop.
From a philosophical standpoint defensively, how do you guys do that? I mean, how do you look at a team like that that's so big and they're going to really probably try to establish their front court players? How can you counter that?
Well, it's about, like I said, it's a five-man effort. Yeah. It's not going to be one guy. We're all going to have to, you know, get back in transition, build our shell, as we called it, and let them get into our paint. You know, penetration from the pass or the dribble. So it's really us forming our shell, as we like to call it, protect that paint and try to do that all game long.
You know, just a question on watching the team so far. It's obviously a different defensive structure scheme than we saw last year. How are your guards working pick and rolls? We see a lot of the guys coming over those pick and rolls looking for potential traps. What are you telling your guards in terms of looking out for those screens that can come from both sides of the floor?
Well, it starts from it's a total team effort. It's not just the guards. Communication is a huge thing there. Our bigs have to be letting the guards know that the screens are coming. And then the guards really have to get into the basketball and fight over those screens. And that's something we're working on. Our guys are doing a great job with that.
What have you thought about them running the triangle? I mean, the jump from game to game to game, we're starting to see the offense a little bit smoother. Guys seem to seem more comfortable in it.
I think it just shows that there's been a lot of work in the last 6 weeks almost now, starting from training camp, that the guys have been very patient with us and willing to learn things and new things, and I think it's going to slowly evolve over time.
And finally, the secondary scoring options. We've seen some guys step up with JR having a good game, you know, in Cleveland, hitting some big shots down the stretch. Shump now, he finds a way to help Melo and offset what he does. How do you sort of, you know, draw that up? Or is it just maybe a game-by-game basis? Or is it a matchup-by-matchup basis?
I think it's just the way the system works and the way that, you know, true team basketball is you hit the first open man, and if he's open, he shoots the shot. And it could be some person one game. It all depends on sometimes how the other teams are playing you. So it could be somebody different each night. I think that's the beauty of team basketball, and that's something that we're trying to really get accomplished here.
Yeah, it's been fun so far. We're excited about it. And an interesting matchup in Detroit. I know they've struggled a little bit to get things going, but always a tough matchup with Stan Van and those big boys down there in Detroit, right?
Yeah, it'll be tough. They're well-schooled, well-coached, and they're going to be ready to play.
We always appreciate your time. Thank you so much.
Thanks, guys.
There he is, Brian Keefe, right here with the scouting report on Knicks.com.